What is up, you guys? Welcome back to Brick Me Up, Scottie. I'm Scottie Ho, you're watching Beams, where I review alternative bricks. And if you don't like it, you can suck my bricks. And if you like it, you can still suck them. Welcome back, Chris.
Hello, everyone.
Yeah, so I'm really sorry. Videos are coming in slow. I'm very busy. If you have not watched my older videos, go watch them. Some behind the scenes stuff. And hopefully those are out. Anyway, I got an upcoming concert with my father. I got to work on that. So I'm going to be really busy. But you guys want to see bigger sets, so here's a big set for you. This one is slightly older. Still pretty cool. I like this idea and this concept. So what you're looking at is from Reobrix, otherwise known as Juhang. This is their European Century Series. This one is the Book Nook 66026. 2,922 pieces! I do not have the box, unfortunately, but the manual here is like a nice, very thick book. Did I have any issues with this color? So some of the bricks. Reobrix likes to use beige or not quite white or vanilla pieces that might get mixed up, or sometimes the lighter tone bricks get mixed up with other colored bricks. But this one was actually pretty okay. It's not too difficult. Just to give you a better idea. The focus is good, right?
Yeah.
So if I go like that, it's still gonna be in focus, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, look at that. Oh, I love this camera, man. Cool.
Yeah, so fast.
Yeah, so quick, right? So there you go. Very nice book. And it actually does have the part list on the back there. So I'm probably missing a bunch of pieces. Who knows? Unfortunately, there are stickers. The sticker sheet is here. Now, the thing is, most of the stickers get used at the end of the build. I would recommend putting them on as you're building. Apparently I screwed up one of them, so I didn't put the sticker on because some of the bricks are blocking the way. But anyway, you do have stickers. Some of the stickers are a little bit oversized, still look pretty good. And it looks really good without the stickers to me too. So your choice, man. This thing is so massive. It's so big. It's a book nook. So the idea is that you're supposed to put this with all your books. Do you guys read books? I don't read books. Chris, do you read books?
No.
We're all video games and movies, man. Screw the books. Now, anyway, you're supposed to put this on your shelf. Does it look really big to put on the shelf? Sure does. And you're supposed to put all your little books next to it. So it looks really pretty. It looks like probably one of those advertisements that you've seen on your Facebook, which you're probably going to see now. And it's like little decoration wood pieces that they put together, and you put it in your book nook or your bookshelf, and it looks really pretty. This is the idea for this one. Reobrix are pretty cool. I met them in the booth in the expo. That's also in the video. But anyway, they're really cool to me, and they're explaining like all these designs are original, and I really like their stuff, man. They have a whole medieval theme set. If you have not seen, I haven't even done any videos for it. You can find plenty of those on YouTube. If you want me to, I have the castle set, which is similar to Big L's castle set, but they have a bunch of medieval stuff. Oh no, I did. I did a fishing one, and I'm already forgetting what I reviewed. Anyway, they're keeping with the medieval theme, and yo, I really like this. I had so much fun putting it together, but it is massive. So just to show you guys here, which is very dark, but thankfully this one has lights. Now you guys know how much I hate lights, but if it's hidden and it's really easy to install, then I'm all for it. And this one was actually pretty easy to install. So let me just show you the exterior first before I turn on the light. Well, there you go. That's what it looks like there. And then the side here, it's just a bunch of patterns, man. There ain't nothing there. The back here has a little tiny hatch that opens up. Now, before I open that, just to show you here, it's pretty much more or less the same kind of thing. You're not supposed to see the sides or the back at all. But if I come back here to the back, let's see if I can open this sucker up here. And go, boo, there we go. Ah, you can see the wire here. You probably want to stick this somewhere, but that looks kind of dangerous. I think light bricks break pretty easily. So for this set, it's totally fine to keep it in there. It's kind of hard to get the switch on. I need to use my tweezers. The light switch is here. Let's flip the sucker on. There, it's on now. So when it closes up, it might catch. So you have to kind of be gentle there. I'm gonna leave the light on from now on. And it's probably not gonna make a huge difference. You can't see it, right, Chris? Too hard to see?
A little bit.
Yeah, Chris, you can turn off the lights right now. Let's just do this earlier. He has to be very careful he doesn't hit the camera. One of my lights broke, man. Hold down. Yeah, there you go. Ah, now you can see the lights. There you go. So the coolest thing is this thing really does open up. And is it easy to open up? Yes. It opens up just like a book. What do you know? So if I open up here, get a better idea. All the lights are here and they have strands that kind of go to here. Now I can't see it from here, but Chris, does it look good like this?
Yes.
Could it be more stronger?
Could be.
Should be, right? You probably add more lights here if you want to, but hey, they included lights and it's easy to install. I'm all for it. Great. There you go. That's what it looks like. It'll probably look even better if it's darker. Right now, the lights are on the outside of the office. Now, this is actually pretty sweet. If you have a medieval town and you kind of just want to have a backdrop that doesn't have a back, this actually might look really good like this. When I took this thing from my home to the office, nothing really fell apart. A couple of the flags might pop out on you because they're a little bit loose. And I like how everything kind of slants out a little bit. And you can see that even the pavement area or the building at the bottom, it has a very slanted feel to it, so it's not straight. I love looking at this thing, man. The pebbled look, the medieval look, I think it looks great. You build each section from the bottom to the top. Now it might actually catch down here as you try to close it, because see like that? You have to kind of like push up and down, and this one too might catch onto the other side. You can see I can kind of open it and close it easy, but you just have to be aware of that. You might have to push up some of these plates here. It's not perfect, but hey man, damn, that was actually really good. You can actually see here where the wires feed through the lights. I just kind of wish they were brighter. So you pre-install the lights as you're building it, totally fine, easy to do. I mean, the only thing that's kind of loose is the rooftop pieces might pull out on you, and they have that typical rooftop look from all the medieval sets. And you can see the color of the bricks. This is very similar to light gray, but it's not quite a light gray. I kept getting that mixed up. But this set is fairly straightforward, so you should be okay. Lots of little windows. Unfortunately, there's no back. You can see the blue background, and I like how everything's like brick. There's no stickers, there's no cardboard pieces. Thank you. It looks totally fine like this. Now, as we go down, this area looks kind of like a pub entrance or whatever entrance you want it to be. A weapon shop, maybe it's a weapon shop. I like the swords that are hanging down there. The doors can't open, but of course it's just a wall there. So this is really just a display piece. Background, man, I'm telling you, this is like a really good background to shove in the back of your table when you have all the buildings in front. So this area here is like a little church. I like it, man. It's actually really similar to the Royal Bay. Remember that one, that big set? We had to take that set down, man. I stepped on it. You probably had to put it on the floor and that was the worst thing to do. But anyway, it has a similar vibe and feel with the crosses here, how you designed that window. I like the little trans clear pieces here. But man, yeah, these are all stickers going along here, here, here. But thank goodness they really broke it up with this look, because it would have looked all the same if it was like the same kind of building look. So it's nice that you have a church in the middle and you got the weapon shop. We're gonna say this is the weapon shop here. So on this side, reminds me of Lord of the Rings, man, when they're all trying to hide. And it's like a tavern, or I don't know what it is, man. Use your imagination, have some fun with it. Same deal with the rooftop part here. It can be a little bit like these pieces might pop off on you, and it's kind of built upwards, so it's very thin, not too fragile. And like I said, I didn't have any problems bringing it to the office, but I like the look of it. I like the brick, the chimney side here. The window pieces look really good. You have more flags hanging out there with more stickers on it. Once again, it's all a display piece. There's nothing behind this building. And as we move to the bottom, you got this little alleyway here. Rawr, the monster's coming through there. That's actually pretty cool. I did a terrible job on the stickers there. I didn't put the sticker on because it's covered by this brick. I had to remove this piece to put the sticker on. I'm like, oh, I should have done that earlier. So put your stickers on earlier if you can. It'll be a little bit easier for you. And then more pebbled walkway here. And you got some flag poles here. I think this is the easiest piece that can pop off. So just be aware of that. It's just, that's an easy fix, man. More of that rooftop style here. Some flags here. And it's nice, the depth is good enough that you can close this whole thing up and nothing will really like pop off on you or get stuck. And I like the breakup, man. Just the whole vibe and look of this side is actually pretty cool in the detail. It's just the stickers on the flag. They're a little bit sticking out. You might want to trim those, cut them off, or don't use any stickers. And of course, if I do close it like this, just to show you here, and I really love this like a tunnel look to it with all the bricks protruding out on the side. And some of these are just supposed to like offset them a little bit, like make them look more crooked. It's up to you how you do that. We're gonna put a figure inside to see how it looks to scale. And I got my medieval guy, Lego guy from the medieval blacksmith shop, which my kids were playing with, so I'm probably missing pieces on him. So here's the figure, chilling out on the sidewalk. He kind of goes together, right? Looking pretty good, guy. Now he's by the front door, right? He's like, Scottie, you're missing a piece right there. Yeah, I know. I'm missing a little brown piece that goes over there. You'll probably get a missing piece here and there. Normal. Scottie, I like this big orange door. And I like how they use a bone for a door handle. That's pretty creative. Hey, man, what's inside this place? That looks like a piece of gear. Scottie, you didn't tell anybody what that is. That's because I have no idea what it is, man. Display, yo. What kind of sword is this? This ain't no axe or heavy sword. I think that's like a ninja sword, man. That probably belongs in their brand new book nook, which you can see right here, the Ninja World, which is also available. Brand new, it just came out, it's on the store right now. And also Star Revenge, the Star Wars style themed book nook. Damn it, Scott. You must buy them and build them. Hurry up. Yo, dude, what are you doing with my sword, man? You didn't put it back? No way, I'm keeping this for myself. I gotta bring this into church with me, cause we gotta go fight some demons. Yo, you look pretty good there. I like that. You can scatter a bunch of minifigures around here and look pretty good. Oh, I like this little alley area here, except you did a crap job with that sticker. I'm gonna come over there and stab you right in the heart. You offended too many people by not applying and applying stickers really badly. In fact, it's so bad, I need to get myself a drink in this place. Hey, this ain't no bar. Where the hell's the bar at? Maybe it's over here. Hello? Anybody home? Get me out of here. I'm done with this thing.
And there you go, and you can still close this whole thing even with the figures on the set. Go like that. There you go.
This is awesome, man. And as I mentioned, you can pick up the whole thing. I lied this thing flat like this, and it was totally fine. You can do it like this. Do you want to be doing this? Probably not. Everything's like shifting, moving around, but there you go. I'm being gentle with it. You can see on the bottom, there are multiple plates here, and everything's still super sturdy. So if I stand this back up here, I feel like a magician. Abracadabra. Everything's still intact, nothing fell off. How awesome is that? Now we will do dimensions, and I'm afraid to drop this thing, but I think it'll survive. The rooftops will probably fly off in the flag. All right, you guys, it is time for dimensions. Break out your base plates. This one's gonna be very odd. I assume you're gonna leave it closed. Take out your base plate here, and if I put it like here, that is around 18 studs that way. Unfortunately, you'll need two base plates. You wanna go this way, which is around 36 studs by width. I'm confused, man. Whatever direction you wanna put this in. If you open it up, well, I'll show you the back. I didn't show you this way. When you open it up, it's like this, right? And I put the plates here. Yeah, you see, it's gonna be like way more. Dude, you need like three. I can't even see it on that side. Definitely over two base plates. Here's the third one for you guys. It's around like 68 studs fully opened up. If you want me to lift up this whole thing and kind of go like this, this thing is like a giant brick, man, and rotate. This is like so ghetto way of doing dimensions for you guys. Poor Chris has to keep up with me. Okay, if I put it to the end here in one plate, so it looks, oh man, there we go. Slap it together, just to give you an idea. All right, it is pretty big, man. Let's stack this up, break out your 1x4 bricks for the height. I'm gonna put it here, and it is just roughly around 31 bricks in height. There's your dimensions. The moment of truth, guys. I asked Chris, should I drop this closed or should I drop it open? He said, Scotty, have some balls, open it up and drop it like it's hot. Here we go. Oh, I'm scared, man. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Chris is impressed. Only a couple things fell down. The rooftop, I told you. Loosey goosey. Yo, dude, nothing like.
Yeah.
Nothing else moved, man. Holy shit. I was a little janky now trying to get it in. Let me see if I can close it up. No, this part for sure got shifted. There we go. It's fine, guys. It's intact. No worries for the rest of your days. Okay, time to move on. Whew! Yes, thank you. So there you guys go. The book Nook from Reobrix. It's real cool. I like this thing. Perfect. Do you have space for it? No. Do I have space for this? Probably not. You know, if I do close it up and just put it away, I think I can get away with it because it's so skinny, but it's got a lot of depth. Anyway, this is available on my store, brickmeupscottie.com, with all the other Reobrix sets. If there's any more, I don't know. I gotta check if there's new ones out. And Juhang as well for the military stuff, which I should review for you pretty soon. Been a while since I've done military stuff. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. I'll be back soon. All right, you guys, until next time, bring me out.